everyone, Hannah here. Welcome back to the channel. For everyone that's new, welcome. My name is Hannah. I love all things Disney, Loungefly, Star Wars, Harry Potter. You could probably tell I figured I would show my Disney wedding dresses today. Now, this video will be in two parts. This is part one, which is just showing the wedding dresses. Yes, I had two. I'll get on to that. Part two will be, I'm going to kind of talk about, because people have messaged me and asked me about it before, so I'm going to talk about how I planned our Disney wedding. We got married in September 2017 in Disney's wedding pavilion. So I'll talk about the planning process with that, obviously with Disney. Now the price, I will be completely honest and open about the pricing as well. Pricing has changed since then, but obviously for our pricing, completely honest and open about it. But I thought today I would show the wedding dresses and I'm gonna be a bit brave and get into them. So I did have two gowns. Now originally I had Belle. And then the live action Cinderella film came out and I fell in love with Cinderella. Tried her on and I was obsessed. My parents were kind enough to buy Belle as my gown and then had a discussion with Mum. I was like, do you mind if I get a second one? Because it's a Disney wedding. We were having parks, pictures inside the parks. She was like, no, do what you want. So had to get Cinderella as well. I did wear each gown three times. So in my head, that made it worth it. So this one, the Belle gown, was the ceremony one that I actually wore during the wedding. It was the, they're both Alfred Angelo, who obviously, unfortunately, now is no longer in business. I think it's now Allure Bridal that does the Disney gowns, which I will come on to later as well, because they've been released for this year. This was the first ever Belle gown that he did. Themed, obviously, on Belle, Beauty and the Beast. I think this one was released in 2011 or 2010, so quite a while ago now. The live action Cinderella gown was released obviously just after the live action Cinderella film. Now I went with sleeveless because in the Florida heat, you're not going to want sleeves. I did try on the option with sleeves, but it just felt a bit too much. Now both are princess gowns, because big ball gown, why not? I did try on a few different sorts, so I will pop some pictures up during this video at some point of all the ones that I tried on. Some I loved. I narrowed it down to three before I chose Belle. And the first ever gown I tried on, which I'll pop a picture of that up now actually, was the Elsa gown. It was the first ever time an Elsa gown had been done. And I think because I'm short, I'm like 5'1", it just swallowed me. Now you would think a princess gown would swallow me, but thankfully that didn't happen. Elsa just on the mannequin, stunning. On me, not so much. Yeah, I'm going to show you a close-up. I had a real quick Google. This is the Alfred Angelo Belle 206 gown. It was the first Belle gown that he did. And there is like a shoulder part that does come off. So I'll show the back properly in a bit. Completely sparkly jewelled corset. I think it sat just on my hip. It is a corset or back. I'll show the back in a bit. And then going further down, a full tulle ball gown, obviously longer at the back, which I will show properly. Now these bits kind of go over. There's one part that goes over that way and then underneath it another one that goes over this way, which will probably be easier to show when it's actually on. But yeah, bottom nice and plain, lovely long train. Look at this sparkle. Sorry if you can hear the cat in the background. He's obviously not allowed out right now because I don't want big old scratch marks in the gowns. So this is the back of the Belle gown. Completely laces up, which took Mum a while, bless her, but it looked lovely. This part goes underneath, and then obviously you use these parts to lace it through. Now this bit is the shoulder part. The seamstress put a couple little buttons on there, which secured just there, so it didn't go flailing around if there was any wind. I'll pop that in there for now. And then you can see the two side poofy parts again, just there. She is a little bit creased, but obviously being stored away. Beautiful long train. She's so pretty. So I am slightly biased, but this was my favourite of the two gowns. If you've seen the live action Cinderella film, Alfred Angelo did kind of like a copy imitation of her wedding gown. Obviously, like I said, mine didn't have sleeves, covered in flowers. So this was the Alfred Angelo live action Cinderella 252 gown. You could get this in this kind of champagne colour with the coloured flowers, or they did do a white version where the gown and the flowers were just white as well, so you didn't have to have colour. But there are little sparkly bits in with the flowers as well. I think this top layer is organza. I'm pretty sure that's what the top layer is. You should look at the detail on there. So there's quite a few layers to this one. Obviously the top layer with the flowers and then more of the tulle underneath. I think that next layer has like a bit of shimmer to it as well, which is so pretty. But yeah, this is the gown that I wore for our Magic Kingdom shoot. So Cinderella is a butternut back, and you can see there's more flower details on the back. Now she is hung on the top of the door, so you probably won't be able to gauge the full length of the back. But hopefully when I put her on in a few minutes, you'll be able to see it better. She is ridiculously long. Like I said, you can't really tell right now because she's hung up on the door nice and safely. But again, all the way around the dress has got these beautiful flowers. And again, you could get it in this champagne and multicoloured sort of version, or a complete white version. I'm in the gown. I am not going to show you the back because that is a hot mess. So when I first had this gown, if you've seen any of my videos before, you might have seen the hospital video and some of my medical stuff. I was in a very bad medical state at that point. I had lost a heck of a lot of weight and I went down to about 7 stone. So the dress was, the seamstress was phenomenal. You couldn't even tell that she had altered the dress. I think it was like 2 sizes-ish that she needed to take it in just because of that one. Medical mess. So it's a little bit, it is tight, it's fully corseted up, but I'm not going to show you the back because it is a hot mess. But I'm in the dress now. Cinderella is a button up, so that might be a bit more difficult, and this keeps popping up. There are little buttons on there though that she put on, but again, little bit bigger since then. Do you know what, it feels really nice actually. Oh, Paige, you okay? Look. Oh, I knew this was here. I'm at Mum and Dad's right now. Mum's been storing my dresses for me. And Mum was sure that the bouquet was here somewhere. Now, I had faux flowers because I wanted to keep it. And Disney, for the Disney Brides, they gave you little boxes with bits and bobs in there. I think my husband had a coin, a handkerchief. And I had, as something blue, this little pendant. Hopefully you can see it. I'll show it properly in a sec. And it says, Faith, Trust and Pixie Dust. So I decided to tie it around my bouquet. I had purple and red. Our theme was like lilac-y purples and red. Beauty and the Beast mainly, but it matches Cinderella as well. Oh, Lord. Oh, I'd forgotten. Mickey's. I'm going to have to show you this close-up in a bit. Just wanted to show you again. Oh, this bit keeps coming up everywhere. I think I had my hair in a bun and I had a little slip-in tiara. I'm gonna have to find all that stuff for when I do the other wedding video. Because originally I had like a proper crown type tiara. We got it from a wedding fair that we went to, and I had my hair trial when we were over there, had my hair in the bun, about to put the tiara on. Bless it, the hairdresser was amazing. Hair and makeup was amazing. I'll talk about that in another video though. And the tiara, some of the crystals just fell out. Out of nowhere, she looks horrified, bless her. She was like, I didn't do it. And I was like, oh no, you didn't do it, it just fell off my head. So we ended up going to Disney Springs to get one of those little slip-on tiara things that you can just have by a bun. So it wasn't the big full crown, but it was still beautiful and a bit more magical because we got it from Disney. But I did also have little seashells in the bouquet. And you're pretty. I feel like a bride again. Da, 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 da. So I'm in Cinderella, but she's not properly fastened at the back. It's easier with a corset because you can just pull and heave ho, but a zip doesn't want to go all the way to the top. We'll just go back down again. I'm in love with this gown. I've always said to my mum, I've considered selling the Belle gown, but I don't think I could ever part with Cinderella. Even though she doesn't fit, I would rather pay to have her enlarged to fit me. But she's just so beautiful. I mean, look at all this detail. If I just pick up some of the front bits, just look at this. She's so pretty. And I have got heels on, but I don't really wear heels. For the actual wedding, I wore white Converse with sparkles all over them. My husband and the men had purple Converse. So that's why I'm stood still right now, because I feel like if I move with heels on, I'm going to go flat on my face. So the bell gown I wore for the ceremony, we had a dessert party in Epcot in the Norway Pavilion, and I switched out into Cinderella for that one. Only three people knew that I had that gown, so when I turned up and everyone else kind of looked, everyone did a double take as if to say, that's a different dress, and I was like, I know, and it was so cute. There was a little girl there, because they lead you kind of through the back of Epcot, and through the back, we were in the Norway Pavilion, and this super cute, adorable little girl went, Mummy, it's Cinderella, and I was like, oh my god, she thinks I'm Cinderella, I'm a Disney princess. So I had my days as a Disney princess. I did take the flowers because I figured they match kind of both gowns. Probably matches Belle a little bit better, but I feel like she matches both. We had a photo shoot in Universal Studios in the Harry Potter sections. That was in the Belle gown. Then we had Magic Kingdom and Epcot. Those were on different days because you had to get up like really early for both. Magic Kingdom and Epcot. I had Belle. No, this is Cinderella. I'm confusing myself now. Cinderella for Magic Kingdom, because Cinderella Castle, you have to. So, I figured this is probably the best and easiest way so you can see how long she is. Look at this! Look at this beauty of the train! And look in the light, how she shimmers. So beautiful! So this is my wedding bouquet. Like I said, they are faux flowers, so they're going to last forever. Well, hopefully. I went with like lilac-y, purple and red. Red ribbon at the bottom. And then this is the little charm that I meant. So it says faith, trust and pixie dust. So obviously something blue. Green underneath for the flowers. It's so pretty. It's actually quite light as well. Like it looks heavy, but it's not that heavy. Kind of similar to the Cinderella gown, when you hold the Cinderella gown on the coat hanger, she is heavy. But when she's actually on, she doesn't feel that heavy. I think she's kind of, because she's secured to you. But yeah, there's little Mickeys in there as well. Little Mickey crystals. And then I got a couple starfish. I think I have two or three. So there's another one. And there's another one. Yeah, so I've got three little starfish. A little Mickey there as well, look. With the pearls. It's so pretty. So as well, the other day, Disney Fairytale Weddings released the 2020 collection for the Disney Bridal Gowns by Allure Bridal. They look stunning, absolutely beautiful. I'll start popping pictures up of them. I think there's Cinderella, Snow White, Rapunzel, Tiana, Sleeping Beauty. Have I said Snow White already? I probably said Snow White already. They look so, so stunning. And then, because it is the Walt Disney World 50th anniversary this year, they have gone and blown it out of the water. So there's an aerial gown, pop picture up. This is kind of the normal, say normal, aerial gown, nice and floaty, like waves. They have done a one of a kind dress that is covered in sparkles. How beautiful is that gown? I can't even imagine the cost of that. It just looks so, so beautiful. I like sparkly things. I'm drawn to sparkly things. So I would have loved to have tried that dress on. I've been dropping hints about doing a vow renewal. We got married in September 2017. So much has happened in the last couple of years that every now and again, I drop hints of, We should do a vow renewal. I think he's maybe starting to come around to the idea a little bit at a time. But imagine, so there was me thinking, oh my goodness, when we go back to Florida later on in the year, we'll find her stockist, try that dress on, depending on the price, see what it's like. But no, it's a one-of-a-kind dress, and Disney have put on a competition to win it. Now, the downside is you have to be within the US to enter. So, sad face. But whoever wins that dress, beautiful. So those are my two wedding gowns, Belle and Cinderella from the Alfred Angelo collection. Hopefully you've enjoyed seeing them as much as I've enjoyed putting them back on again. Now I know they don't fit properly, but way hey, things happen. I will do another video on kind of the planning that I did for the Disney wedding and the mess that was Hurricane Irma that decided to rear her nasty little ugly head in September 2017. That's a completely different story. So make sure to like and subscribe and hit the notification bell for that one. Thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!